I use Arabic calligraphy as a tool to connect my culture and other people's culture, and I always say that my artwork is here to create bridges between people, culture, and generation. And I'm using Arabic culture as this tool to creating those bridges. And here, like in the middle of Cambridge, I'm using the words of this poet, Veronica Forrester Thompson, who was part of this British poetry revival. Follow the reader and his writer, those emblematic person along their mythic route, charting its uncertain curves and camber. I just love the first sentence that says, follow the reader and his writer. And for me, what she wanted to show is like, as a writer, you don't exist if there is no reader. As an artist, I don't exist if there is no audience. And that's what creates actually this connection between you and society in general. And I think as an artist, I wouldn't create if I knew there was nobody here to appreciate what I'm doing. Since yesterday and today as well, we have people coming, and so I trace and they fill up the colors. So it's for me a way to also give back the piece, you know, like, so somebody maybe in a year or two will be like, okay, this part, I'm the one who filled up this pink part on the wall. So you give this sense of belonging, you know, they're like, okay, this piece belongs to us. It's not just a guy who came and put it enough, you know. So it's important, I think, to engage with the people. I mean, like, if it was like the summer, I think I wouldn't be here. Like, I would just be like chilling down, like drinking some juice and letting people filling up all the letters. Most of the time, that's what I do. I don't do anything, I just trace. And I'm joking.